Hello students, hope you all are doing well. So let's start our online geography class, and we are continuing the chapter 5, natural and man-made disasters. In my previous class I already discussed about the causes of disaster. So today I'll telling you what is disaster and the main causes, and then I'll discuss on the two types of disaster, natural disasters and man-made disasters. Okay, actually you know the life is extremely unpredictable. Human life is constantly subjected to the dangers of nature or human miscalculations. This may be occur due to human negligence, error or intent. Actually, a disaster is an event that occurs suddenly and causes major loss of life and property. It disturbs the environment and leads to economic loss too. Hence, awareness and preparedness, always remember, awareness and preparedness, two important thing. These two important things are very necessary to cope up with the effects of disasters. Okay. Now we already learned that what are the causes of disasters. What are the causes of disasters? Here are some causes why disasters occurs. The first one is socio-economic backwardness. Actually, poverty and illiteracy causes lack of awareness, and it is a fact that it is generally the poor people who live in hazard exposed areas, they are affected very much with the disasters, with the devastating disasters, they affected very much the poor people. Actually, poverty and illiteracy goes hand to hand with the lack of awareness. Whenever there is poverty and illiteracy, there is lack of awareness. And the next point is lack of proper planning and inadequate training. Actually, it is also a very important cause, because this make the effect of disaster a devastating one. Lack of proper planning and inadequate training to cope up with the disaster. Okay. And next, third point is population explosion. A major problem nowadays, it is population explosion. Due to population explosion, actually overpopulation, it is causes what the demand of land increases. As the due to overpopulation, demand of land increases, and for that what occurs? Forest depletion, illegal building construction, inefficient drainage system, these all are harmful to nature and it causes devastating disaster. As we harm the nature takes its revenge. Okay, so disaster comes to us and affect us devastatingly. Next, number four, over utilization of resources. You know that over utilization of resources is a main point to cause disaster. How? Actually, you know what are natural resources? Land, water, these all are natural resources. Plants and trees also. Actually, over mining causes soil erosion. And soil erosion causes what? Landslide, debris flows. These all occurs due to over mining and soil erosion. Next is overuse of surface and groundwater. groundwater is the usable water only, you know, and overuse of it, misuse of groundwater leads to drought and water scarcity. Next is depletion of forest. It causes imbalance in nature and imbalance in natural ecosystem. And imbalance, whenever imbalance of natural ecosystem occurs, it causes pollution, it increases pollution, okay. And the last point is global warming, very important point. Due to global warming, glaciers are melting down and sea level increases. As glaciers melting down, sea level increases, and increasing sea level causes what? Loss of land. How? Due to submergence of islands and coastal areas. So these all are the causes of disasters, okay. Now based on the origin of disasters, these disasters can be categorized in two types: natural disaster and man-made disaster. Disaster two types. Always remember, natural disaster and man-made disaster, okay. So these are two types of disaster. Actually, man-made disaster, human-made disaster, we also cause some disaster, okay. So what is natural disaster? Natural disasters are caused by forces of nature, and this disaster causes this disaster occurs suddenly, which these natural disasters are powerful, uncontrollable, and occur suddenly, as I told you before. Such disasters can cause severe damage to life and property. It is very difficult to recover the losses. So what are the example of natural disasters? Floods, earthquake, droughts, and volcanic eruptions, and tsunamis, cyclones, these all are natural disasters, okay. So today I'll tell you about natural disasters. So let's go to the book and I'll tell you elaborately, okay. Firstly, let's discuss about flood. Floods are mostly caused due to heavy rainfall, swelling of river water, dam collapse, cyclones, tsunami, etc. Actually, when water in rivers overflow their banks, there is a dangerous rise in the water level, which submerges the surrounding areas like villages, farms, and roads, and thus flood occurs. So what are the causes of flood? Many factors like heavy rains, melting of ice and snow or glacier, or failure of dams can cause rivers to overflow and thus resulting in floods. Human activities like deforestation, colonization of river beds, poor quality dams, and improper drainage also cause floods. Floods are common in countries like China, Thailand, India, Pakistan, and Bangladesh. You know, unlike other disasters, flood advance slowly. In India, floods occur during the monsoon season due to heavy rainfall. The Ganga plains, Brahmaputra basin in Assam, And the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers experience frequent floods. So these were the causes of flood. And now I am telling you about the impact of flood. Actually, impact of floods may be negative or positive. Firstly, I will tell you about the negative impacts. Point number one, floods can cause loss of life and property in plains. Number two, a flood can ruin agricultural output and cause huge loss of food grains and livestock. Crops are washed away by the strong water currents. And next point is, flood usually lead to landslides in mountain regions. And next point, fourth point, as floods destroy homes and habitats, millions of people are rendered homeless. Floods lead to the contamination of drinking water that causes outbreak of waterborne diseases such as malaria, diarrhea, jaundice, cholera, etc. These all are waterborne diseases which are the after effect of flood. Always remember. Overall, all people face shortage of food and safe drinking water. Flood affected area are cut off from other areas. Whenever flood occurs, flood affected areas are cut off from other areas due to the submergence of roads and railway lines. In coastal areas, agricultural land turns saline because the sea water washed away the agricultural land. So, the agricultural land became saline due to the tidal flooding and so become unproductive. Saline soil is not productive at all. Fertility decreases so that they become unproductive. Overall, floods destroy crops and infrastructure, thereby adversely affecting the economy too. These all are the negative effect of flood. Now, what are the positive impacts? Let's find out. Actually, as flood waters sweep over an area, they deposit fertile silt over these areas. Flood waters sweep over the area and this flood water deposit what? Fertile silt over these areas. This silt make the soil along the banks of the flooded rivers very suitable for farming. These silts are actually they grow the fertility in the soil so that the soil become fertile and suitable for agricultural work or farming. Next point is, floods help to increase the levels of groundwater. As the soil seep the rainwaters, so the groundwater level rises. As the groundwater level rises, the usable water also increases. Clear? And the next point is, flood waters, if properly stored in dams and lakes, it can reduce water crisis. So, these three are the positive impacts of flood, always remember. Okay? So now let's learn that what measures should be taken to reduce the risk of flood. First of all, mapping of flood prone areas is essential to prepare for precautioning measures. Okay, so what is the first point to reduce the risk of flood? Mapping of flood prone area is essential to prepare for precautionary measures. Next point is, rise in the river water level should be closely monitored. Okay, and alert signals should be issued when the danger level is crossed. Next point, river embankments should be constructed to check the spread of flood water. Next point, evacuation of livestock and people should be done from vulnerable areas. And a most important point, warning should be given through the mass media such as television and radio. And buildings in coastal areas should be built on stilts or on pedestals, and walls of houses must be made flood proof. And disaster management kit, it's an important, very important disaster management kit must always be kept ready, which includes first aid kit, food stock, fresh water, clothes and other essential items such as candles, matchsticks, torches, sticks to ward off snakes, this is also important, etc. And the most important is, an efficient disaster management team should be organized in the local area. So, adopting such measures of flood preparedness, it can check their disaster's effects. Now, let me tell you elaborately about the project. Your project is on natural and man-made disasters on this chapter, and you have to prepare two case studies which given in your book. Any one from floods in Assam or earthquake in Nepal. Okay? And the second case from oil spills, coastal areas of US and coastal areas of US. There are two such case studies, oil spill in Alaska or Gulf of Mexico oil spill, any one of them. So, any one of them, this floods in Assam or earthquake in Nepal, and any one of it, oil spill in Alaska or Gulf of Mexico oil spill. Okay, clear to you? Hope most of you know the project format, but for your better convenience, I am telling it to you again. Okay? So, first of all, wrap the project file and write your name on it. And first page, you should write your index. Okay? Second page, acknowledgement. Third page, introduction. You should write the introduction about what is disaster and the main causes of disaster. You should write in few lines the introduction, what is disaster and the main causes of disaster. And next is the main body. Main body is the two cases. You write first case and then the next case. First case is natural disaster, and the next case is second one is human-made disaster. You write it and then write the main body. Causes and impacts. You just write causes and impacts of this disaster. Next is conclusion. conclusion is disaster management on and awareness is necessary. Why this disaster management and awareness is necessary? Write down only that. This is conclusion. Okay. And lastly, bibliography. You know what is bibliography? From where you collected the informations. Okay. These are bibliography. Okay. So, I think the project is now clear to you. And collect pictures from net, or you can color Xerox of book also granted. You can paste these pictures also, color Xerox of book from any book. Okay, so you can collect the pictures from net, otherwise color Xerox of your picture of the book. Okay, so do your project, and in my next class I'll discuss on the other natural disasters. So till my next class, bye.